Every year, fall Chinook salmon endure a journey of more than 500 miles to return to the Snake River in Hell's Canyon, some of the most remote and rugged territory in all of North America.
That's pretty unique. That's a long distance for a small fish to move back and forth.
Now, modern technology in the form of drones and tiny cameras is helping to chart the ancient ritual that signals the return of these resilient fish.
They start off as juveniles here in the river, and then as, you know, small fish, 3, 4, 5 inches long, juveniles that they're migrating downstream over 500 miles of river to the ocean. And they'll spend a couple of years out in the ocean, milling about in the Pacific Ocean, and then turn right back around as adults 2, 3, 4 years later and come right back up to the same river locations almost and start the whole process over again to spawn.
It's a dangerous journey, but more and more are surviving the trip. Idaho Power biologists, state and federal agencies, and the Nez Perce tribe have conducted an annual survey of the fish's nesting areas, called REDS, since 1991 as part of a basin-wide effort to support the salmon.
I think in 91 there were between 600 and 700 adults that actually came back into the Snake River Basin to spawn. And throughout Snake River, the main Snake River, the Clearwater, the Amnaha and Grand Ronde, where we did all of our surveys, we only counted 42 nests, total of 42 reds. And now, 24 years later, what we're counting are upwards of 6,000 reds between all of these different river systems. And we'll see probably close to 3,000 to 4,000 reds just in the main stem Snake River.
Conducting those surveys used to require helicopter flights through Hell's Canyon in unpredictable winter weather. Biologists would look out of the helicopter and count reds, which show up as light gray patches against the dark river bottom.
There have been accidents doing red surveys, not with Idaho Power, thankfully, but other entities, Nez Perce Tribe, Idaho Fish and Game, they've had some crashes in the past, and it's been pretty devastating. So when we can get the human being out of the air, that's great.
The drone allows biologists to get an even better look at the river while remaining safely on the ground. They travel by boat to key salmon spawning locations and record the reds from above.
The main advantage is safety. That's really the main advantage. Drones they're inexpensive, and they can go places that we generally can't go with a helicopter. Another advantage that we do get is that we can fly lower. We can see clearer what's going on at the spawning areas, and we actually get a good captured image that we can go over again and again and again.
Those images play a key role in helping Idaho Power and others support the survival of the fall Chinook.
So it's been a unique experience to see such a change.
For more about Idaho Power's fall Chinook flow program, visit idahopower.com/ourenvironment. Reporting for E! News, this is Brad Bolin with videographer Lon Van Wyk.